Joshua chapter 11. The northern kings defeated. When Jabin king of Hazor heard of this, he sent word to Jobab king of Madon, to the kings of Shimron and Aksab, and to the northern kings who were in the mountains in the Arabah south of Kinnereth, in the western foothills, and in Naphoth Dor on the west, to the Canaanites in the east and west, to the Amorites, Hittites, Perizzites, and Jebusites in the hill country, and to the Hivites below Hermon in the region of Mizpah. They came out with all their troops, with a large number of horses and chariots, a huge army as numerous as the sand on the seashore. All these kings joined forces and made camp together at the waters of Merom to fight against Israel. The Lord said to Joshua, "Do not be afraid of them, because by this time tomorrow I will hand all of them slain over to Israel. You are to hamstring their horses and burn their chariots." So Joshua and his whole army came against them suddenly at the waters of Merom and attacked them. And the Lord gave them into the hand of Israel. They defeated them and pursued them all the way to Greater Sidon, to Misrephoth Miam, and to the valley of Mizpah on the east, until no survivors were left. Joshua did to them as the Lord had directed. He hamstrung their horses and burned their chariots. At that time, Joshua turned back and captured Hazor and put its king to the sword. Hazor had been the head of all these kingdoms. Everyone in it they put to the sword. They totally destroyed them, not sparing anyone that breathed. And he burned Hazor itself. Joshua took all these royal cities and their kings and put them to the sword. He totally destroyed them as Moses the servant of the Lord had commanded. Yet Israel did not burn any of the cities built on their molds, except Hazor which Joshua burned. The Israelites carried off for themselves all the plunder and livestock of these cities, but all the people they put to the sword until they completely destroyed them, not sparing anyone that breathed. As the Lord commanded his servant Moses, so Moses commanded Joshua, and Joshua did it. He left nothing undone of all that the Lord commanded Moses. So Joshua took this entire land, the hill country, all the Negev, the whole region of Goshen, the western foothills, the Arabah, and the mountains of Israel with their foothills, from Mount Halak, which rises towards Seir, to Baal Gad in the valley of Lebanon below Mount Hermon. He captured all their kings and put them to death. Joshua waged war against all these kings for a long time, except for the Hivites living in Gibeon. Not one city made a treaty of peace with the Israelites, who took them all in battle. For it was the Lord himself who hardened their hearts to wage war against Israel, so that he might destroy them totally, exterminating them without mercy, as the Lord had commanded Moses. At that time, Joseph went and destroyed the Anakites from the hill country, from Hebron, Debir, and Anab, from all the hill country of Judah, and from all the hill country of Israel. Joshua totally destroyed them and their towns. No Anakites were left in the Israelite territory. Only Gaza, Gath, and Ashdod did any survive. So Joshua took the entire land, just as the Lord had directed Moses, and he gave it as an inheritance to Israel according to their tribal divisions. Then the land had rest from war. Joshua chapter 12. List of defeated kings. These are the kings of the land whom the Israelites had defeated and whose territory they took over east of the Jordan, from the Arnon Gorge to Mount Hermon, including all the eastern side of the Arabah. Sihon, king of the Amorites, who reigned in Heshbon. He ruled from Aroer on the rim of Arnon Gorge, from the middle of the Jordan to the Jabbok River, which is the border of the Amorites. This included half of Gilead. He also ruled over the eastern Arabah, from the Sea of Galilee to the Sea of the Arabah, that is the Dead Sea, to Beth Jeshimoth, and then southward below the slopes of Pisgah. and the territory of Og, king of Bashan, one of the last Rephaites who reigned in Ashtaroth and Edrei. He ruled over Mount Hermon, Saleka, all of Bashan, to the border of the people of Geshur and Makkah, and half of the Gilead to the border of Sihon, king of Heshbon. Moses, the servant of the Lord, and the Israelites conquered them. And Moses, the servant of the Lord, gave their land to the Reubenites, the Gadites, and the half-tribe of Manasseh to be their possession. These are the kings of the land that Joshua and the Israelites conquered on the west side of the Jordan, from Baal Gad to the valley of Lebanon to Mount Halak, which rises towards Seir. Their lands Joshua gave as an inheritance to the tribes of Israel according to their tribal divisions. The hill country, the western foothills, the Arabah, the mountain slopes, the wilderness, and the Negev. The lands of the Hittites, Amorites, Canaanites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites. The king of Jericho, 1. The king of Ai, near Bethel, 1. The king of Jerusalem, 1. The king of Hebron, 1. The king of Jarmuth, 1. The king of Lachish, 1. The king of Eglon, 1. The king of Gezer, 1. The king of Debir, 1. The king of Gedor, 1. The king of Horma, 1. The king of Arad, 1. The king of Libna, 1. The king of Adullam, 1. The king of Makeda, 1. The king of Bethel, 1. The king of Tappua, 1. The king of Hefer, 1. The king of Aphek, 1. The king of Lasharon, 1. The king of Madon, 1. The king of Hazor, 1. The king of Simfron Meron, 1. The king of Asphath, 1. The king of Tanach, 1. The king of Megiddo, 1. The king of Kedesh, 1. The king of Jokneam in Carmel, 1. The king of Dor in Naphod Dor, 1. The king of Goim in Gilgal, 1. The king of Tirza, 1. 31 kings in all. Joshua chapter 13. The land still to be taken. When Joshua had grown old, the Lord said to him, "You are now very old, and there are still very large areas of land to be taken over. This is the land that remains. All the regions of the Philistines and the Geshurites, from the Seir River on the east of Egypt to the territory of Ekron on the north, all of it counted as Canaanite through the held by the five Philistine rulers in Gaza, Ashdod, Ashkelon, Gath, and Ekron, the territory of the Avites on the south, all the land of the Canaanites, from Ada of the Sidon as far as Aphek, and the border of Amorites, the area of Byblos, and all Lebanon to the east, from Baal Gad below Mount Hermon to Lebo Hamath. As for all the inhabitants of the mountain regions from Lebanon to Misrephoth Miam, that is all the Sidonians, I myself will drive them out before the Israelites. Be sure to allocate this land to Egypt for an inheritance as I have instructed you, and divide it as an inheritance among the nine tribes and half of the tribe of Manasseh. Division of the land east of the Jordan. The other half of Manasseh, the Reubenites and the Gadites, had received the inheritance that Moses had given them east of the Jordan, as he, the servant of the Lord, had assigned it to them. It extended from Aroer on the rim of the Arnon Gorge, and from the town in the middle of the gorge, and included the whole plateau of Medeba as far as Dibon, and all the towns of Sihon, king of the Amorites, who ruled in Heshbon, out to the border of the Amorites. It also included Gilead, the territory of the people of Geshur, and Makkah, all the Mount Hermon, and all Bashan as far as Saleka, that is the whole kingdom of Og in Bashan, who had reigned in Ashtaroth and Edrei. He was the last of the Rephaites. Moses had defeated them and taken over their land, but the Israelites did not drive out the people of Geshur and Makkah. So they continue to live among the Israelites to this day. But to the tribe of Levi he gave no inheritance, since the food offerings presented to the Lord, the God of Israel, are their inheritance as he promised them. This is what Moses had given to the tribe of Reuben according to its clans. The territory from Aroer on the rim of the Arnon Gorge
and from the town in the middle of the gorge and the whole plateau past Medeba to Hezbon and all its towns on the plateau, including Debon, Barmodbal, Bethbal Mion, Jahaz, Kedmont, and Mephab, Kiriathaim, Sibma, Zeret Sahar, on the hill in the valley, Beth Peor, the slopes of Pisgah, and Beth Jeshimoth, all the towns on the plateau, and the entire realm of Sihon, king of the Amorites, who ruled at Hezbon. Moses has defeated him, and the Midianite clans, Evi, Rechem, Zor, Hor, and Reba, princes allied with Sihon, who lived in that country. In addition to those slain in battle, the Israelites had put to the sword Balaam, son of Beor, who practiced divination. The boundary of the Reubenites was the bank of the Jordan. These towns and their villages were the inheritance of the Reubenites according to their clans. This is what Moses had given to the tribe of Gad according to their clans. The territory of Jazer, the towns of Gilead, and half the Amorite country as far as Aroer near Rabbah, and from Hezbon to Ramath, Mizpah, and Betonim, and from the Mahanaim to the territory of David in the valley, Beth Hara, Beth Nimra, Sukkot, and Zaphon, with the rest of the realm of Sihon, king of Hezbon, the east side of the Jordan, that territory up to the end of the Sea of Galilee. These towns and their villages were in an inheritance of the Gadites according to their clans. The territory extended from Masaim including all of Basan, the entire realm of Og, king of Basan, all the settlements of Jair in Basan, 60 towns, half of Gilead, and Ashtaroth and Edrei, the royal cities of Og in Basan. This was for the descendants of Machir, son of Manasseh, for half of the sons of Machir, according to their clans. This is the inheritance Moses had given when he was in the plains of Moab across the Jordan east of Jericho. But to the tribe of Levi, Moses had given no inheritance. The Lord, the God of Israel, is their inheritance as he promised them.